रेड लेड वाली पेंसिल नटराज।
आई लव यू रसना।
देयर इज अ सॉन्ग ऑफ केके, हम रहे या ना रहे कल, कल याद आएंगे ये पल। This video is specially for such nostalgia lovers. Come join me in this journey to relive the childhood of 90s kids in India. We will look at the silly, simple and sometimes quite out of the place things which many of us still remember. Let's begin with little things in our school life. We will start with school bag. Ours was something similar, a horizontal bulky bag with two straps, which was always sold to us as a waterproof bag. Well, it was waterproof for sure, as long as it was not raining. These colorful Milton water bottles, which were too big to quench the thirst of the whole family, but we had to carry these each day to the school. Our other memorable school stuff was this Camlin geometry box, Nataraj pencils. There was also an ad with the famous tagline, "Aur Nataraj, phir champion." Then we also had these pen pencils, which were the most annoying invention, as whenever we began writing, the lead inside the pencil would break instantly. Then there were such chart papers to tell us moral tales of life. These two-sided ink erasers, which hardly ever worked. Then this inkpot ink dropper, and both of them were used to fill the most coveted fountain pen. We also had these multicolored pens, double-sided pencil boxes that opened from top and bottom, and also the coolest pencil box at that time, this button-operated magnetic pencil box. In school days, these brown cover papers and notebook labels were also very important. I remember my mother and I used to cover my school books together, and I used to write my name on these notebook labels. Moreover, in school, we also used to fill slam books, which were a mixture of the profile pages of LinkedIn, Facebook, and a bit of Tinder. Also, the games we played inside our classrooms included pen fight, book cricket, name place animal thing, and the very scientific flames, where you find out with utmost certainty that the girl you have a crush on, will she fall in love with you, marry you, or become your sister. Yes, the choices were so contrasting, and the funny thing was that some of us took the answers very seriously. Now from school, let's talk about another favorite of every 90s kid, the video games of that era. Nintendo NES, although it came to India in the 80s, in the early 90s too, it was the most sought after possession of any kid, and these game cartridges were more precious to the kids than gold itself. The most nostalgic games of Nintendo were Contra, Circus, Adventure Island, Duck Hunt, where you literally shoot a duck with a gun, the iconic Super Mario, and my personal favorite, Kung Fu, where you fight to save Sylvia from the evil Mr. X, whose laughter many of the players will still remember. Other than Nintendo, Sega was also popular in the 90s. While the most loved games of Sega were Sonic the Hedgehog, Aladdin, and for the cricket-loving kids, there was Brian Lara 96 Cricket. In 1995, Sony too launched its first PlayStation console. Moreover, in 90s, our toys included Hot Wheels, He-Man, G.I. Joe, Barbie doll was loved by girls, and the most popular comics were Champak and Tinkle, with Supandi and Shikari Shambhu the most known characters, while Asterix and Obelix and The Adventures of Tintin were the most loved international comics. There were also these handheld games, which claimed to have 100 games inside, but usually only played Tetris in 50 different versions, while my favorite handheld game was this parachute game, which was released in the 80s, where you are given the heroic task to save people from the sharks in the water. There were also some crazy and fun products in the 1990s, like this painful slab bracelet, which could also be used as a ruler. There was ice cream ball. Yes, it was a plastic ball with ice cream inside. Then there was ice cream sandwich, Pepsi Cola, the most affordable soft drink inside a plastic, these light shoes by Action. And we also had a cigarette for kids. Yes, a sweet cigarette shaped candy with a red dot called Phantom Cigarette. Also during that time, Boomer and Big Babool were competing to win the chewing gum market share. And behind them were Chiclets, Big Fun, which came with a free cricket card, and Fusion Gum, which was the most expensive. Many of these chewing gums came with a stick-on tattoo. The joy of making the first tattoo on your hand and showing it to your friends was priceless. After that, Kiss Me. Don't get me wrong, this was actually the name of the brand, Kiss Me Bar. Then there was Mango Bite, Pan Pasan, Parle's Rola Cola, and the most popular soft drinks in the early 90s were Rasna and Gold Spot. There were many other cola drinks in the 1990s. If you want to know more about them, check out our awesome documentary on Cola Wars of India. Moreover, in the 90s, some of the offbeat games we used to play were marbles or goti and a game called Lagori, where you simply stack up stones and hit them. Also, while playing cricket, the most sought after bat was the one with a power sticker on it, as Sachin Tendulkar used to carry a similar bat before he switched to MRF. Talking about cricket, Sachin was undoubtedly the biggest star of 90s, and the most memorable cricket matches of the decade were the 1992 World Cup semi-final between South Africa and England, where in a rain-affected match, the scorecard changed from 22 runs from 7 balls to 22 runs required from just 1 ball. Other memorable matches were Sachin's remarkable back-to-back century in Sharjah, where there was also a desert storm in the middle of the match. Then there was a series played in Canada, where Ganguly almost single-handedly won the Sahara Cup against Pakistan. Also, there was the Five Nation Hero Cup in 1993, and also the infamous semi-final of 1996 Cricket World Cup at Eden Garden, when the crowd stopped the match by throwing water bottles on the ground, while the decade ended with Kumble's historical 10-wicket haul against Pakistan. Furthermore, during the 90s, WWF, now called WWE, was also hugely popular amongst kids. We used to play with WWF trump cards, while the most followed WWF superstars of the decade were Bret Hart, Undertaker, Stone Cold Steve Austin, The Rock, and the unbeatable Yokozuna. In the early 90s, video cassettes of WWF were the only source of watching it. We used to go to our local video cassette parlors, where you could rent a movie or a WWF cassette and bring it back home to play it in a VCR. By the end of the 1990s, video cassettes transformed into CDs and VCRs changed to CD players. Also, it was the decade when personal computing and internet began in India. To connect to the internet, we had to connect via modems, which used to make an annoying and loud dialing sound every time you connect, while the computers ran on Windows 95 or Windows 98. Our 90s nostalgia journey is not over yet. There are a lot more memories to cover. 90s music, movies, our crazy TV shows. If you want to see the second part of this video, then let us know in the comments. I'm Naveen, and thanks for watching The Filmy Cut.